I shaking? I hope not. It is me, Saren, back with another car video. So a lot of you guys have been highly requesting a video on The Rock playing John Henry. I want to start off by saying I find it to be really, really funny and ironic that this got announced right now and that this kind of sort of like blew up and became a big story. Because the story of John Henry is a prime example of Black American folklore and mythology. So, if you're unfamiliar with this story, I would definitely recommend looking it up, and I will also, of course, have relevant links in the description box. But the story of John Henry is loosely the story of a steel worker. As with many sort of folk tales, it is believed that this story was loosely based on a real person, but folk heroes generally could be real, they could be fictional, and the point of a lot of folk tales is to have a fictionalized, you know, account, a fictionalized story with a moral center, a moral kind of core. And a lot of the times folk tales are used as a way to kind of tell life lessons, right? Especially to young, you know, young people and children. Like John Henry, there was a old Disney cartoon made about it. A lot of the times it's published in like children's books and stories. Again, it's like a child story as a way to kind of portray a life lesson. In many iterations of the story, John Henry is an escaped slave or a freed slave or a slave that bought his freedom and kind of went on to become a steel worker that went up against a machine when it came time to build a new railroad, right? Like it's kind of a classic man versus machine type of story. And ultimately John Henry and his two, you know, steel hammers ends up besting the machine. And in some iterations of the story, even though he bests the machine, he dies at the end. Like there's various, you know, iterations of the story, but ultimately it's a story about, you know, humanity and human strength and, you know, heart over machinery and all that types of stuff. Y'all know I'm all on board with that because y'all know how I feel about motherfucking Terminator Rise of the Machines. So that is a prime example of, I hope it's not making too much noise. The part of the road that I'm on is bumpy as hell, so my camera is fucking shaking. How about we fix these roads, infrastructure? Anyways, so that's a classic example of a Black American folktale. Classic example of Black American folklore and mythology that is very much rooted in the Black American descendant of American chattel slavery experience. Like the whole, like I said, the backstory of the story generally revolves around him being some type of escaped and or freed slave. So, a lot of people felt some type of way when it was announced that The Rock was going to be playing John Henry in a live-action movie adaptation of this folk story. I believe I might have also read that The Rock might also have a hand in producing it, but you don't have to hold me to that. But I think that's what I read. And a lot of people understandably were like, this ain't it. Like, this ain't it. Like, this is definitely an example of what we've been talking about in terms of people being able to double and triple dip in and out of culture when it suits them. I like The Rock. Like, I like The Rock. I fuck with The Rock. I like a lot of his movies. I also really enjoyed his wrestling career. So I don't have no personal beef, no personal problems with The Rock. Me personally, I don't. However, here is a person that definitely has racial ambiguity. There's a whole lot of like, is he or isn't he? What is he? What is he not? You know, here's a person that was able to play in Gridiron Gang, which is one of my favorite movies. I love that movie. If you have not seen it, you should definitely watch it. But here's a person that was able to play in Gridiron Gang, which is about a man that starts a football team in a juvenile detention center. And in real life, that dude was like white. And The Rock is able to like play that character, right? And then he's also able to play like Maui and Moana, who's like a Samoan demigod in the Disney cartoon Moana. Now, yet again, we've talked about, does race and ethnicity matter in voice acting? I have a video on that. Part of why The Rock was chosen was for authenticity. They wanted to use Samoans, they wanted to use Hawaiians, right, as the voice actors. And then now we have, oh, he can also play John Henry. Like, that's a lot. That's a lot of moving in and out of cultures and being what, you know, whatever you want whenever it is convenient for you. And that's just something that doesn't sit right with a lot of people, and understandably so, especially when you're talking about, you know, a piece of Black American folklore that is rooted in American chattel slavery. The Rock, whose mother is Samoan, she's from Hawaii, and his father is Black. He is a Black Canadian. He is from Nova Scotia. But I do think that The Rock is not the right person for this role. I could see why, well, aside from the racial ambiguity factor and the mainstreaming of Black American culture to make it more palatable by moving in racially ambiguous faces, by moving in foreign Black faces, by moving in, you know, these again, much more palatable for a mainstream, i.e. white audience, as a way to kind of tell Black American stories and co-opt Black American culture in a way that makes it for everyone, which we also talked about when Prince passed away, and you saw these people talking about, well, Prince was for everyone. Like, Prince was a nigga, and he was not shy nor quiet about it, you know? So as a way to kind of, again, continue to mainstream our culture, mainstream our stories, make it so that our own culture, our own ethnicity, our own heritage, our own folklore, you know, our history, make it so that these things don't belong to us, they belong to everyone. Definitely The Rock being in this role is another example of that, due to his racial ambiguity and the fact that he has the ability to kind of double and triple dip and then play John Henry, who, I mean, even in the Disney adaptation of it, like, he was a dark-skinned, like, not racially ambiguous at all, you know? So I definitely am not on board with this casting. Like, honestly, for me personally, I would prefer a up-and-coming, unknown, dark-skinned, DACS male actor for this type of role. I'm not really with The Rock, who is a mainstream star, which people are gonna say, like, well, he's a mainstream bankable star, so of course they wanna use him, but he's still not appropriate for this role. John Henry exists in a really specific space in terms of the nature of the story. So it's kind of like, why can't we get descendants of American chattel slavery in at least some of these roles? It's interesting. It's an interesting conversation. So I don't think The Rock is appropriate at all. I definitely think that, again, this is an example of what we were talking about in terms of the mainstreaming of Black American, again, culture, history, stories, folklore, ethnicity, heritage, making it palatable for everyone, turning it, again, into this thing that just anybody could fucking put on and take off like a coat whenever they fucking feel like it. And I'm not with it. It's not appropriate. I don't think that it's appropriate. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments. Food for thought, as always. See you guys next time. Peace.